Well, the first snowfall of the season turned into a blizzard for Crow Wing County. Our Logan Gay has more on how the Crow Wing County Highway Department has been working hard to keep up with the heavy snowfall.
The Crow Wing County Highway Department has been working since 7:30 this morning, plowing the roads.
Right now, we've got all our trucks out. We are trying to fight with Mother Nature again. The first one of the year is going to be a good one, it looks like. We're expecting 12 to 18 inches in Crow Wing County.
After last year's mild winter, this blizzard is one of the most severe storms they have seen in a while.
Rate that it's coming down in the wind is up there with the pretty severe that we've seen the last few years especially.
The Crow Wing County Highway Department has been using their precise GPS technology and salt to help with the snow removal.
It's helping with our efficiency, and then also when we get calls from customers asking when their road is going to be plowed, we can give them a little better idea of where our trucks are at.
One resident said it didn't take long for the weather to take a drastic turn.
When we came here this morning, it was mostly rain and sleet, and there wasn't much on the roads. And then I went back to grab my daughter and mother-in-law, and there was a lot more snow. I've already been out twice to shovel the front, and it's just didn't even look like I did anything the first time.
And many stores like Cactel's Books and Gifts in downtown Brainerd are left without power because of the storm.
And we lost power here at the store. I'm not sure if somebody ran into a power line or just the weight of the snow knocked something down, but so we're out of power here as well. But we're able to keep running, keep open, because we've got the Wi-Fi on our phones to do all of our business transactions.
The Crow Wing County Highway Department encourages motorists to drive safely. In Brainerd, Logan Gay, Lakeland News.
According to the State Patrol, as of 4:30 this afternoon, the Brainerd District saw 83 vehicle spinouts or vehicles off the road and 33 crashes. Three people were injured in the crashes, but none seriously, and no one died.
If you've enjoyed this segment of Lakeland News, please consider making a tax-deductible contribution to Lakeland Public Television.